the Cape Horn 32. With an overall length of 31 feet 10 inches, a beam of 9 feet 1 inches, and max horsepower rating of 700.
All right, a Florida company that's been around for a long time is the Cape Horn. I know you've seen them before, and they used to be all roll gunnel.
They did, Dave. They really came in as almost an entry-level boat way back decades ago, and they came from Pensacola, that whole area. And you knew when you were getting close to Pensacola because you started seeing Cape Horns. Man, have they come a long way.
They really have. They've dressed up their boats a lot. Now, this new 32 that we have here is absolutely gorgeous. They've got a molded ring deck, so you've got the look of a molded interliner. But what I love about it is they've stayed with their tried and true interior finish. It's super tough, and what I love about it, it's a breeze to clean up.
Not only that, but unmistakable lines. I mean, if you see that boat coming down the highway from a mile away, you know it's a Cape Horn. It's a gorgeous boat.
Well, they've kept the toughness that's made their company famous, but they've added enough fishing features and family features to this boat to really compete with any of the other center consoles on the market. Well, normally we start at the front of the boat, work our way back. I want to start the middle of this boat at the console because that's really a focal point, and it's got some features I know you're going to like being a fisherman.
Most people that buy big outboards run them themselves. You don't very often see a hired captain on an outboard boat. That means the boat owner, the man that makes the decisions, is going to spend at least 75% of his time right here. Every inch has to suit him.
Well, it really does, and we talk about this all the time. Ergonomics and getting the console to fit you is really the most important thing when it comes to picking out the style of boat that you want. If you're going to have electronics, pick your electronics, make sure they fit. A lot of the big units now won't fit in the smaller consoles.
Having the console the right height, okay? How about a solid windshield all the way up? You can't get wet standing behind this windshield.
Well, you can. I ran this boat today, and you don't get any wind in your face. You can run with your hat on, which is something you can't do in a lot of boats. But the comfort factor, these seats are really comfortable, whether you're standing or whether you're sitting. This is a boat you're going to take to the islands. There's no doubt about that.
And it's extra important to be comfortable.
Well, it is, but something I know is going to definitely be important to you, you're going to love this cockpit. It's got a huge live well right where you like it, and I have not seen a top with this many rod holders yet, but they're exactly where they belong. All right, Rick, big cockpit, bait well where you like it, check it out.
I love that, Dave, but I gotta tell you, a lot of people have a misconception about carrying so many rods. Carrying so many rods isn't about, oh, you can only fish four or five at a time. No, it's not. Carrying so many rods is about time management, okay? You and I are going sail fishing when sail fish don't bite. Well, 9:30 in the morning, we may wanna bail and go snapper fishing, okay? We may wanna make a drop for a daytime sort. It's really planning out your day is the reason to have so many more rods, and so many more rod holders makes that possible.
What I like about this area, though, you don't have to move very much. This is a big boat, so if you had to move a long distance in rough seas, it would be tough. Your bait, it's right here. Your rods are right here. You've got your area here that's an insulated place for your rig bait. Let's say you're gonna troll ballyhoo or something like that. Even a freshwater washdown, you've got a fold-out seat that we've seen in so many other boats here in the stern, which we always have said that's the most comfortable place to ride. But if you don't want it, it's out of the way. If we're back here snapper fishing, you don't have to move but in this little area.
No, you don't, and the live well is critical because if you're gonna have one this size, and this one you can take a bath in, it's gotta be in the center of the boat. People don't understand how much difference that much water makes to the weight you're running with.
All right, I really like what Cape Horn did with their transom here. Like we said earlier, you have an insulated bait cooler on this side. You've got storage here, but it lifts out. It gives you easy access to all your systems. Your batteries are back here. Your fuel filters are back here. It makes a great trash receptacle. You know, you're going to have leader. You're going to have hooks. You're going to have maybe pieces of bait through the end of the day. You can throw it down in there. Like you say, lift it out, dump it out. These are little things that the boat manufacturer took into consideration. When Cape Horn designed this boat, they designed it around the fishermen. They also designed it around the family. So you have one boat that can do both. All right, Rick, we've seen this before in a lot of boats, but when you put seating up here that's this comfortable, this is where the family's gonna hang out.
Well, this is for something other than running 30 miles an hour offshore, there's no question. This is a place for a meeting place, if you will, if you're at the sandbar, if you're cruising the intercoastal on Sunday afternoon, going to the restaurant.
It is, but let's say we wanna fish. All these cushions are removable. There's storage under here. The size of this fish box right here, even the fish that you catch, plenty of room that'll fit.
We're talking about a process of evolution, Dave. Cape Horn started out as a rolled gunnel boat. It was hardcore fishing, that's what they did. They've come into something now that your wife and daughter would be proud to be in anywhere they wanted to go.
I love the design of this boat. It's got the look and feel of a full interliner boat, but like I said earlier, it's still got the toughness of their interior finish that I just absolutely love.